Hello friends, in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss the different types of the direct measurement liquid type. So very first type in the direct level measurement is a dipstick and the lead line. Now first of all, we should know what do you mean by direct measurement or direct level measurement of the system. So direct level measurement is nothing but we can say it uses the direct measurement of the distance from the datum line and used for primarily location indication. So it is not easily adopted for the signal transmission techniques for the remote indications or the controls. So this direct level meant this system can be used for the distance from the datum line and are used for the primarily for the location indication. So the first measurement system what we have to see is a dipstick and the lead line. So first of all, let us see the diagram related to this. So this shows the dipstick and the lead lines. Now in this, what we can see, you can see a tank which is full of the liquid and there is a stick. And on that the marking levels are marked over here. So in this what you can see, while units are normally in the percent or the length, volumetric units can be derived as for the cylindrical tank we have to measure the volume, and this shows the steel tape or the bob type of the liquid measurement. So in this dipstick there is a flexible lines which are fitted with the end weight called the chain or the lead lines have been used for centuries for suffering men to gauge the depth of water under their ships. So these steel tapes having the pump balls, these steel tapes having the plumb balls like weights and the stored continually in the reel are still used extensively for the measuring the level in the fuel oil bunkers and the petroleum level gauges. So what we have seen here? It offers the simple and inexpensive means of the measuring level. So it can measure the liquid level only approximately. That means it cannot give us the accurate level measurement. And this is why these are not used for the signal transmission techniques. So these are giving us the approximate values. So these dipstick are giving us the approximate values and it can be measured the liquid level only for the approximately. Now what does it consist? Dipstick consists of the metal bar on which the scale is etched. So you can see here, this is the metal bar and the scale is etched on the metal bar. And this will show us the level of the liquid. The bar is fixed at the known position in the liquid containing vessel. So it consists of liquid. And a level measurement is made by removing the instrument from the vessel and reading of the how far up the scale the liquid has weighted. So how we are going to find the measurement? It consists of a level measurement. It is made by removing the instrument, that is removing the dipstick instrument from the vessel and reading of how far up the scale is liquid has weighted. So that is how we can measure the level of the liquid. The another diagram which we can see here, that is a steel tape and the bob. So this steel tape having plump bob like weights and stored conveniently in the reel are still used extensively for the measuring level in the fuel oil bunkers and the petroleum storage tanks. There are some advantages and the disadvantages related to the dipstick method. Now what is the advantage of this? First of all, it is very much a simple construction. It is having the simple construction. This can be used for the direct measurement purpose for the datum line. But it is not reliable. The first disadvantage is it is not reliable. Because it gives us the approximate value And if it is giving us the approximate value for the level measurement, definitely it is not reliable system. And in this, it will not provide the accuracy. So in that, it first requires the action to be performed, thus causing the operator to be interrupted in his duty to carry out the operation or to carry out the measurement. So the advantage is it is having the simple construction. It is used for the direct measurement. But the disadvantage is it is not reliable. It will not provide us the accuracy. So, it is not dependable because it is not providing us the accuracy and it is not reliable system. Now, the next direct measurement system is the side glass. Now, what do you mean by side glass? Let us see. So, in this diagram, it can show you the two diagrams for the low pressure side glass and the high pressure side glass. So, it is again the straightforward method for the measurement system. In this, the level in the glass seeks the same position as the level in the tank. So, it provides the continuous visual indication of the liquid level in the process vessel or the small tank. And these are convenient for the dipstick and the manual gauging tips. Now, here we can see the two diagrams, that is for the low pressure side glass and the high pressure side glass. Now, the side glass A, that is a low pressure side glass, it is more suitable for the gauging an open tank. The metal ball is normally used in the tube to prevent the fluid from flowing out the gauge. The tabular glass of this sort is available length up to 70 inches. So it provides the glass tube up to the 70 inches in the length, where the continuous visualization is possible in the glass, this A type of glass. So this A type of glass, it provides the continuous visual indication of the liquid level in the process vessel and a small tank. Now these are more convenient than the dipstick and the dip rod manual gauging tips. Now here what we have seen, this is divided into two parts, A and B. So this A is a low pressure side glass and B is for the high pressure side glass. The side glass A is more suitably for the gauging an open tank. A metal ball normally used in the tube is to prevent the fluid from out the liquid glass or the gauge. Now this tubular glass of this sort of available in the length of 70 inches and it can hold up the pressure up to 600 psi. Now this is related to the low side glass. The other side glass, it is the B type, which is used for the high pressure. The closed tank side glass B, which we have seen in the diagram. So this is the high pressure side glass B. So what does it have? It has the special metal column and the tampered glass window is used over here. This tampered glass window, it is not used in the A type of the side glass, but it is used in the side B glass. So this closed tank side B, sometimes it is also called as reflex glass. It is used in many pressurized and the atmospheric process. The greatest use in these pressurized vessels such as boiler drums, evaporators, condensers, stills, tanks, distillation columns and other such applications, these are used. Now the next is chain or the fourth gauge. Now what do you mean by this chain and the fourth gauge of the measurement system? Let us see. As you can see the diagram over here, there is a float and it is connected to the weight. Now as the weight increases, the position of the float will get changed. As the position of the float will get changed, this pointer will be moving from this position to this position, that is from zero position to the maximum position. Now, the displacement or the position of this float is totally depending upon the how much weight we are connecting over here. So this float is connected to the pulley by a chain or the flexible cable. As you can see here, this float is connected to this weight by this pulley or the chain. Now, the rotating member of the pulley, this pulley is rotating now with the help of this weight. The rotating member of the pulley, it is in turn connected to the indicating device. So you can see the indicating device. This is the pointer scale. So on this pointer scale, it will show you the level of the liquid. So it is connected to the indicating device for the measurement of the graduation. As we can see in this diagram, the float moves upward and the counterweight keeps the cable tight. So this is the weight which gives us the counterweight to the float. So it keeps the cable tight and the indicator moves along the circular scale. So this we can say this is the zero position, this is the maximum position. So as this cable is tight between the float and the weight, because that weight provides the counterweight to the float, the indicator moves from zero position to the maximum position, giving us the measurement of the liquid. Next type is the hook type. Now let us say, what is the hook type of a device? Now in this diagram, you can see there is a hook provided over here. So this is another way of the simple measuring liquid level. In this, when the liquid of the open tank is measured directly on the scale may be in the liquid or outside it. So we can say this is equal to the dipstick. So in this hook type, it is another way of simple way of measuring the liquid level. So what is happening in this? When the liquid level of the open tank is measured directly on the scale may be in the liquid or outside it. So it is sometimes difficult to read the level accurately because of the parallax error. Now what is the main difference between the dipstick and the hook type is? In dipstick, we have used a metal strip and in that the hook is used. But sometimes in this hook type, it is difficult to read the level accurately because of parallax error. So in this case, the hook type of the level indicator is used. So you can see here the hook type of the liquid level measurement. The next type is a displacer level gauge. What do you mean by displacer level gauge? So this diagram will show you the displacer level gauge. So in this, it consists of a nozzle and a flapper. Now this nozzle and the flapper will be moving according to the torque which is given to this rod. Now this is called as displacer. This is showing you the torque arm block, this is torque tube, and this is the flange, and this is limit stop. So with the help of this displacer gauge, you can find out the level of the liquid. So this is one kind of a level gauge. It is used to measure the liquid level on the nearly stationary object called the displacer. So this displacer, we can call it as a stationary object. It is called the displacer because its purpose is to displace the liquid. Now, what is the purpose of this displacer? To displace the liquid. Now, a force is measuring mechanism senses the change in the buoyant phase and the converts this force into the indication of the level. Now this displacer provides a continuous measurement over the range of determined by their length and can be made into the transmitter for automatic level control in the shallow vessels. The displacer moves up and down only when the little wave, perhaps only a fraction of inch. As in the liquid level changes, the buoyant force moves the displacer slightly and the twist or the torque tube. The motion of the torque tube moves the pointer to indicate the liquid level on the scale. The pointer rotation is only from 2 to 7 degree. It gives us the rotation from 2 to 7 degree. So this is the displacer type of the level gauge we have seen. So in the direct level measurement system, first what we have seen, dipstick method. In the dipstick method, it is very much simple and giving us the direct measurement. But what are the limitations for the dipstick? That it requires an action to be performed, thus by causing the operator to interrupt the duty to carry out the measurement. Then the dipstick cannot be used for the continuous representation of the process measurement. Again, what is the another limitation for this? That it is not providing us the accuracy. Again, it is not dependable method for the liquid level measurement. It will limit the effectiveness of the measurement. Next, what we have seen, the side glass. In the side glass, we have seen two side glass, that is A type of side glass, that is for the low pressure measurement, and the B type of slide glass, which is for the high pressure measurement. Now, what are the advantages of that? That again, these are the simple ones, and the length of the reflex glass ranges from few inches to the 8 feet, and it will give us the length of the level measurement. But again, the disadvantage related to the this type of direct measurement, it gives us the parallax error. The side glass type of a measurement gives us the parallax error, and the glass element can be get dirty and are susceptible to the breakage. Thus, the safety hazards can be occur in the side glass. Next, we have seen the chain and the float gauge. In the chain and the float gauge, this method have been used to give the indication of the level from the float position, with the most common being float and the cable arrangement. And the operational concept we have seen in the float and the chain, that float is connected to the pulley and the counterweight is provided to the float by the weight provided to it, and the pulley, the cable is tied between the float and the weight which is provided, and with the movement of that pulley, it shows the liquid measurement on the pointer scale. Then next, what we have seen, that is hook type of the measurement. In the hook type of measurement, it consists of a hook provided here. When the level of the liquid in the open tank is measured directly on the scale may be in the liquid or outside the liquid. So sometimes it is difficult to read the level of accuracy, so it gives us the parallax error. Then the next type of displacer level gauge which we have seen, that is displacer level gauge. It depends upon the buoyant force and it converts that force into the indication of the liquid. And the pointer rotation for this displacer level gauge, it is only from 2 to 7 degree. So this is all about the direct measurement of the liquid level and its type we have seen. Thank you.